speaking exams can fill some students with dread. But don't feel stressed, we have some top tips to help you. Firstly, you need to be prepared, so make sure you practice speaking as much as possible a long time before the exam day. Check how to pronounce words, learn some phrases, and find out what the examiner is looking for. When the real exam arrives, examiner Mark Shea has some good words of advice.
You need to remember that the examiner is not your enemy. It's the examiner's responsibility in an oral exam to provide opportunities for the examinees to display their language proficiency, how good they are at speaking. So the examiner will help you.
So, our second top tip to help you with your speaking exam is to remind you that the examiner is there to help you. They know you're nervous. But it's also good to give yourself the best possible chance as well. Don't speak too fast, slow down. Take a deep breath and speak clearly. And don't forget to listen to the questions, and if you're unclear, ask the examiner for clarification. But to do this effectively and to show the examiner how good your speaking skills are, make sure that you comfortably and accurately use clarification phrases, such as, "Can you repeat, rephrase that please?" Or, "I didn't quite catch that, could you repeat or say that a different way please?" Sometimes speaking exams are done in pairs or groups. Don't let that worry you. Be friendly to the other candidate and maybe even help them with their speaking. Language expert Karen Adams can explain why.
This is because it's important to interact and show the examiner that you can't just speak, but you can actually converse with someone else. Part of your marks will be devoted to the interaction between you and your partner. So remember to react to what your partner says and to ask questions if it's appropriate.
So remember, in speaking exams, the emphasis is often on cooperation rather than competition. If you're confident and friendly, you'll do well. Good luck!